Hello guys, in previous video we have seen electrical properties of the semiconductor, and in this video we are going to see carrier concentrations in semiconductors. So till now we analyzed the electrical properties of devices and their behavior. So it is necessary to think about what is number of charge carrier per centimeter cube in the material. So in previous we have seen electrical properties, their behavior, how they behave when temperature increases or decreases. Now we are going to see what is the charge carrier per centimeter cube in the semiconductor or material, in the given material. So to obtain the carrier concentration, first we must investigate distribution of carriers over the available energy states. So before finding what is the charge carrier, what is the amount of charge carrier per centimeter cube, we have to know what is the distribution of carrier and how a distribution of carrier present in the given available energy states. So for this we have to investigate distribution of carriers over to energy, given energy states, is done by some statistical methods, which is not, we are not going to see what is those statistical method. So but our concern is the application and the results of semiconductor. So we have take the results from here, and that method we will accept here. So but our concern is the application and these reals of semiconductor materials. So we accept distribution functions as given, which explain the distribution of carriers over given or available energy states. So from that method we find a distribution function which is known as Fermi direct distribution function, which could be written as F is equals to 1 upon 1 plus e to the power e minus ef by kt, where k is Boltzmann constant, then the value is 8.62 into 10 to the power minus 5 electron volt per Kelvin, or 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. So first we have to see how a distribution of carrier is present into the semiconductor, and after that we will see the charge carrier per centimeter cube, number of charge carrier present per centimeter cube. So here it gives the probability that an available energy state at E will be occupied by an electron at absolute temperature. So this is the statement of Fermi direct function. Fermi direct function gives the probability that an available energy state at E will be occupied by an electron at absolute temperature T, where EF is called Fermi level, energy E equals to Fermi energy level EF, that occupation probability is this. So at Fermi energy level, the occupation probability will be 1/2, means the electron can occupy that level, the probability the electron can occupy that level by 1/2 probability. So an energy state at Fermi level has probability of 1/2 of being occupied by an electron. This is the same statement at, so this is the diagram of Fermi direct function and with respect to energy. So at T is equals to 0 degree Kelvin, we got this graph, a rectangular graph, sharp graph. But as temperature increases, we have this type of bending in the graph. This is T2. So T2 is greater than T1 here. As temperature increases, bending is also increases thereby. So we can see the symmetry of the distribution of empty and filled states. This is, let us say, empty state, this is filled states. Like it depend on the how material works, whether it is n-type or p-type, or temperature increases, it's totally dependent on the that present condition. So distribution of empty and filled states about EF makes the Fermi level a natural reference point in calculation of electron and hole concentration. So electron and hole concentration we can calculate by using EF as a natural reference point, because above or below EF those electron and hole will be present. So here we see that this graph for intrinsic, this graph for n-type, this graph for p-type. In intrinsic, EF Fermi level present at the middle of the EC and EB, but this is slightly above from middle point. EF level, energy level, is Fermi level is slightly above the middle point because of the energy density greater, because of the electron energy density greater than valency. So here we find the probability of electrons present here, which is normally less. So this is intrinsic type. Here we have n type. Here our Fermi level is towards EC, it means energy of conduction band. This is the edge of conduction band, and here we got maximum number of electrons. Due to this, we can say that as EF being closer to EC, number of electrons will be greater. So EC minus EF gives us the measure of electron. This is EC minus EF. And from p-type, our Fermi level is closer to EV level, which is known as valency energy of valency band is, and the hole will be present here. If electron present here, their probability is FEC, and then hole presentation will be equal to 1 by F in EV value. So at this point, EF minus EV gives the measure of. Above we see the distribution of carriers over semiconductor or energy band of semiconductors. Okay. Next step we will see electron and hole concentration at equilibrium. Electron and hole concentration at equilibrium. To calculate electrons and hole concentration semiconductor, we can use Fermi distribution function. So till now, we know that how an electron distributed over here, or hole distributed over here, or electron distributed over here. So we know that how electron or hole distributed over a energy band, or their probability of occupancy of an energy level. So now, after knowing that distribution, how they distributed, we can calculate the number of electrons or holes from Fermi distribution function we have. Okay, for this, only if we know density of available states in valency band as well as in conduction band. So if we know density of available states in valency band and conduction band, then only by using Fermi distribution function we can calculate the electrons and hole concentration in semiconductor. So how do I define electron concentration in semiconductor or conduction band? So concentration of electron in conduction band, which limits from conduction band A, is to the infinite, and this is the probability of Fermi energy Fermi distribution function, and this total is called energy states, which is per centimeter cube in the energy range dE. So this is condition for in equilibrium condition. So N naught will be equals to this. If we solve this, we can find the N naught value, but for solving this, we have to use some quantum mechanics, some Pauli exclusion principle. We are not going to do that. So we are taking directly result. But before that, from all these two points, we find that n is directly proportional to e to the power 1 by 2, which means that density of states in conduction band increases with electron energy. We could replace it by effective density of states, which is known as NC. So the overall N naught could be written like this: N naught equal to NC FEC. Okay. So FEC is equals to 1 upon 1 plus e to the power EC minus EF by KT. Totally, overall, we can see that the electron concentration and hole concentration will be this. N is equal to NC e to the power minus of EC minus EF by KT in conduction band, and P naught is equal to NB into e to the power minus EF minus EV by KT in valency band. Thank you guys. Next, some topics we will see in the next videos, and please do subscribe for this channel. Thank you.